Psalm 30, a Psalm of David, a song at the dedication of the temple. I will extol you, O Lord, for you have drawn me up and have not let my foes rejoice over me. O Lord my God, I cried to you for help, and you have healed me. O Lord, you have brought up my soul from Sheol. You restored me to life from among those who go down to the pit. Sing praises to the Lord, O you his saints, and give thanks to his holy name. For his anger is but for a moment, and his favor is for a lifetime. Weeping may tarry for the night, but joy comes with the morning. As for me, I said in my prosperity, I shall never be moved. By your favor, O Lord, you made my mountain stand strong. You hid your face, I was dismayed. To you, O Lord, I cry, and to the Lord I plead for mercy. What profit is there in my death if I go down to the pit? Will the dust praise you? Will it tell of your faithfulness? Hear, O Lord, and be merciful to me. O Lord, be my helper. You have turned for me my mourning into dancing. You have loosed my sackcloth and clothed me with gladness, that my glory may sing your praise and not be silent. O Lord my God, I will give thanks to you forever. David wrote this psalm, as the title indicates, for the dedication of the temple, an event that took place after David's lifetime. We see David calling on his fellow worshipers to sing thanks and praise to God. What did the temple signify? The temple was supremely significant in the life of the people of Israel because it signified the very presence of God in their midst. In a sense, Eden had been the very first temple. There, God dwelt with humanity in uninterrupted fellowship. The divine and human, the infinite and the finite, communed. The fall into sin expelled mankind from the garden, however, and God withdrew his presence to heaven. How could their fellowship be restored? The answer that unfolds through the Old Testament is first the tabernacle, which was simply an early portable temple, and then the temple itself. In the tabernacle and the temple, the divine and the human, the sacred and the profane, once more met. They were a tiny, restored Eden. Yet the temple was not God's final answer of how he would dwell once more among his people, for he gave us abundant reason to join David in singing his praise and giving thanks to him forever. We now know just how it is that God's anger is but for a moment and his favor is for a lifetime. God drew near to his people through his own Son, Jesus, not in a building made of stones and wood, but in a body made of flesh and blood. Through Jesus' death and resurrection, God draws near to sinners and enjoys fellowship with us once more. Let us praise him.